What is up? This is Graham Tuttle, the Barefoot Sprinter, and today we're gonna tackle a challenge. If I only had 5 minutes to work on my hip mobility, what would I do? Now, of course, there's so much more time you could spend on this. In the hips, there's a lot of tissue around your hips, your pelvic floor, your lower back, and your thighs that needs a lot of time and attention. So 5 minutes a day is not gonna make massive changes. But just like flossing your teeth, when you do a little bit each day, it keeps the big stuff from building up. And that's what we're gonna focus on, a simple routine you can do for 5 minutes. And we're gonna do a follow along. So I've got my handy dandy timer. I'm gonna time it and get you the direction so that you can work along with me. You could save this, you could come back to it. We're gonna be able to get you moving better with a little bit of movement every single day, flossing for your hips. And one thing to cover before we get started is the space you need. Now, obviously with your hips, you wanna be on the ground because the more you can get on the ground and use the ground as a surface, that's valuable. So having some type of a pad, if you're pretty tough, a yoga mat's gonna work, carpet works just as well. But the more you can get some padding under your joints, so specifically for your knees, that can be really helpful. So having some type of a foam roller or a cushion or a pillow, takes a lot of the pressure off. And if your body can kind of relax into the surface, it lets you stretch a little bit more effectively. So just keep that in mind as you get started. But without further ado, let's get to work. So to get started, we're going to work on a downward dog pulse. Now, let's start our timer and go. You're gonna shift up, hands under your shoulders, walk your feet back. And it doesn't really matter how much you're doing this, where your hands are. If you need to go on your fist, that's fine. You're just gonna walk your feet and pulse and just walk your downward dog out. So you see the rotation, I'm stretching out through the back of my foot and just feeling this. We got about 30 seconds here. 30 seconds, just putting some length, driving down. Don't put too much pressure on yourself to get perfect. We just make this nice and easy, very simple. You should not be out of breath. It should not be challenging. We'll switch to a hip bridge march. So this, instead of stretching us out, is getting the glutes to engage. So you lift up and hold, lift up and hold. Make sure the hips don't drop. What we want to focus on is that we're not just thinking about stretching, because we have to have some muscle engagement. So we want short range where we actively contract the muscle, that gets a lot of blood flowing, and that lets us feel safer for the overall movement we're going to do. As we get 30 seconds there, we're going to stand up and switch back to a standing split good morning. Very gentle, lower down, touch the ground. Obviously, if you can only get here, that's fine. And if you need to be able to just lower down and touch a pillow or a pad, it doesn't really matter where you start. It just matters that you're moving. You'll notice that as you go through this, you're going to have some range of motion that opens up. Again, we're pairing long movements, so we're stretching out the tissue, with short range contraction. It's a back and forth of this entire engagement. And as we switch from that, we're going to drop down to a 90-90 lift over. You're going to lift the foot over in this position. Again, the further away you need to sit, that's fine. We've got 30 seconds each side here. So just very smooth articulation. The stronger you are, the more you'll be able to sit up and have this. But notice, this is a controlled articulation. I think people call this cars or something like that. Your goal is to focus on keeping your hip moving and letting it be smooth. If you need to really lean out to get all the way out, that's fine. 30 seconds in each side. Your focus is just starting to create strength in these hips. This deep hip musculature, because that's really what keeps your body engaged. Is you need the muscles to be able to move so that your fascia remodels with it. Because if you're just doing one or the other, just stretching for your fascia, there's no feedback that you have safety in the joint. And if you're just doing muscle, there's no connective tissue that's moving and remodeling. So you want to focus on both and just make it slow, controlled. It should start to feel more mobile as you get into the reps here. Now, we're going to switch as our timer moves to a couch stretch. So this is going to open up the front of the hip. We've got 30 seconds each side here. Standing tall, and if you can't reach back and grab this, that's fine to lower down. You just want to focus on extending the hips and making sure that there's length coming through the front of the hip. So we'll do 30 seconds on each side. You can open up. If you're feeling really smooth, you can add a little bit more stretch to the front of your body. You can also put this up on the back of a couch, which is why people call it the couch stretch. You lean down, you have your knee down, and you can staying upright, you put this foot back up to really open things up. But again, don't let perfect be the enemy of good. If all you can do is lower down here, open up. One thing you wanna make sure is you're not just opening and extending the back. We wanna focus on keeping this hip extended. So squeeze the glute, open up through the front of the hip, stay tall, and just have this set up so you're feeling the stretch where you want to feel the stretch. Simple as that, working with intention. So opening up, working with what you have, feeling that lengthen. I'm going to switch to a half kneeling tip sit. Now, this is potentially one of the best things you can do just for a floor sitting, just being supporting your body weight, because you're both getting work on a full knee flexion, but you're also opening up the front of your ankle, so or your tibialis muscle. So what you want to think about is you can lean on your other foot, take the weight off, and you can start to expand and open up more space in the front here. It's just a very comfortable sit. If you can get comfortable in this position, it's an incredible way to just work on your hip mobility throughout the day. You can work, you can do a lot. We'll switch sides at 30 seconds. I live in this position. I mean, this is one I learned from my friend Kador Ziani. He spends all of his time here. One thing to remember is that the foot is gonna come across on the inside. So it's not like you're going straight back. We don't need to open up the inside of the ankle. We just wanna think about the natural line that works around the outside of the ankle. We're just sitting here, just breathing, opening up, moving, and if you start to feel a little bit more comfortable, you can start to get more range of motion through the top. But again, even if you have to put a pad on your heel to open up and get less knee flexion, that's fine too. Take the weight off with your hands here. And as our time moves, we're gonna finish the last one, which is a standing roll down. So leg straight, roll down, touch, roll back up. Your goal is to round your back as much as possible, keep the legs as straight as you can, come back down. So don't let the head look up, let the head drop with it. Relax, down, and back up. If you need to soften the knees a little bit, that's fine. You can straighten them on the way back up. It's just getting motion in. And nice, long stretch to the back of the body. And that is our 5-minute timer. The key is to remember that 5 minutes is not going to dramatically change your body. It will make you feel good. You should feel a little bit more alive and sprightly. But the beautiful thing is that once you have this routine down, you can sprinkle this in like a little movement snack throughout your day. You have 5 minutes between a call, great. Pop down the floor, do this, work through some of this routine. The important thing is you get in the habit of treating your mobility like something that can be worked on. If you have something like a flossing routine, it helps prevent the big plaque from building up. That's what we want to focus on here. 5 minutes is a great start. If you want more help with this, more focused exercises to movement or movements around the knee, hip, pelvic floor, spine, lower back, I have a program for you. It's free. It's called Athletic Foundation. You can get started on that today in the link that's somewhere associated with the video. But otherwise, if you enjoyed this, make sure to subscribe, share, and all that stuff. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.